Hi, my name is Courtney Morrison, and I'm an application engineer with Yokogawa's Test and Measurement department. Today, I'm going to show you the analysis feature of WTViewerE. To learn more about the other features of WTViewerE, please click the link below to my other video, WTViewerE, Making Power Measurements Easier. After connecting to the software, you'll notice the analysis button is grayed out. To use this feature, either start and stop a measurement on the measurement screen, or load a file of previously saved data. I'm going to load one of the sample files provided with WTViewerE. Click on the Analysis button to bring up the analysis screen. This screen pulls up all the data saved and allows you to view and analyze that data. All of the same basic settings of the measurement screen apply to the analysis screen. The analysis bar lets you easily scroll through the data. Switch between moving the cursor, zoom window, or both. Drag the knob to move the cursors forward or backwards in time. The further out you drag it, the faster it moves. You can also click through individual data points using the arrows or click on either the graph display, trend display, or waveform display. View the data point and timestamp as you're scrolling. Choose the trend graph you want to see in the graph display by right-clicking the graph display and selecting the trace. You can only choose between traces that you have displayed on the trend window. To change these settings, right-click on the trend window and select the traces you want to be able to see. Another feature only available on the analysis screen is cursors on the waveform, trend, and bar graph displays. Click the cursor display button to display the cursors. Each display has two cursors, C1 and C2, and their values are displayed in the top of the window. Their difference is also displayed as C2 minus C1. To move C1, left-click and drag it. To move C2, right-click and drag it. You can output numeric and waveform data to a CSV file by clicking the CSV button on the toolbar. Select numeric, wave, or both to save. Select the range as all, zoom, or cursor data. For numeric data, choose the compression as none, PP compression, or thinning, and then select the rate you want to output the compression as. Finally, choose where you want to save the file. Whether to auto-name it or not, and if you don't choose auto-naming, type the file name that you'd like. You can also then change the line count of the CSV file. Press Execute to save the file. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit tmi.yokogawa.com.